With another vaccine getting prescribed recently, the summer prognosis looks brighter for America. Even with more recent news, the states such as Texas are removing mask mandates and restrictions. Several industries are even expecting surges, with demand growing higher than ever. In this week's episode of The Portfolio, we'll take a look at what we can look forward to in the spring and summer as we claw back from this pandemic. Never short stopping, now I'm winning like What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula hailing to you from the frozen confines here of Oakbrook Terrace, Illinois, a direct west suburb of downtown Chicago. As the snow thaws and the sun shines brighter, we can only hope that our economy will do the same. So let's bust out our crystal balls and take a look at how some industries are due for a comeback. Jeff Hurst, the president of Vrbo, sees a boom on the horizon for vacation rentals. Quote, every house is going to be taken this summer. There's so much built up demand for it, end quote. Hurst's optimism is based simply on human nature. Just like animals resurfacing after a long hibernation, Americans have been hibernating for a year through this pandemic and are ready to party for a weekend at Bernie's. Also, data from AirDNA, a short-term rental analytics firm, showed vacation bookings for the end of March, which traditionally coincides with college spring breaks, are just 2% below their pre-pandemic level. Now check this out, employment openings on job site Indeed.com are 4% above pre-pandemic baseline. Data on retail foot traffic, air travel, and seated diners at restaurants have all edged up. And economist forecasts in mass have risen, with firms like Oxford Economics seeing a juiced up economy hitting 7% growth this year, more typical of a developing country. As we look at some of the COVID-19 number of cases, we're definitely on the decline after hitting highs in January. So restaurants and air travel should all see a surge. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell had this to say, quote, we are not living the downside case we were so concerned about during the first half of the year. We have a prospect of getting back to a much better place in the second half of this year, end quote. So what does that mean? That everybody's favorite season, which is summer, is due for a comeback. Time to call up John and Jeremy and crash some weddings this summer. Ha! The meatloaf! Now, while the outlook seems rosier on the outside, there are still some areas to be concerned about. For one, jobs are not surging as much. The economy remains about 10 million positions short of where it was in February 2020, and that hole remains a huge concern as we wait another stimulus bill on the Hill. Now, while there is a demand for travel and food, there are still many companies in those industries that sadly closed their doors forever. And this isn't necessarily the type of boom type period to start a new restaurant or travel company. The other aspect to pay attention to is the evolution of digital businesses. Remote work and business travel should not expect a return to normal, for many companies learned to get lean and saw no downside to that approach. Companies such as Facebook, Google, and Zillow have announced that they are preparing for permanent remote work. Companies embracing digital are thriving. Video games saw a huge surge in adoption and usage. Gearbox CEO Randy Pitchford predicts a massive surge in gaming, and the maker of Borderlands 3 has increased hiring to keep up with the demand. While small yoga studios and fitness gyms have been seriously affected by the shutdowns, the online fitness industry is booming. Fitness app Daily Burn saw a 268% year-over-year increase in membership. Peloton's stock increased by more than 400%, and the company has plans to get 100 million subscribers to its fitness platform. Gaming, interactive fitness, telehealth, streaming TV are just a few of the digital businesses that will continue to thrive beyond 2021. The other aspect to staying lean is company relocations. With tax-heavy states like California and New York, also the most restricted states, companies adopting more digital and/or remote work can move to smaller, cheaper cities to save a lot of money without downsizing. Oracle recently announced it is moving its corporate headquarters from Silicon Valley to Austin, Texas. Yes, and even cost savings attracted IBM and Apple to Raleigh, North Carolina. And even many financial services companies have relocated to Charlotte and Miami. Even Tulsa, Oklahoma, and the entire state of Vermont have offered financial incentives for people to work remotely from there. Cities like Birmingham and Kansas City are well positioned to become the next newest mid-size hubs. Nearby airports and large universities easily draw talent, and the low cost of living make them ideal for companies looking to move their operations. Now, my money smart thoughts. So there's a lot for us to keep an eye on for the summer of 2021. My takeaway from all this is a few things. Number one, save your money. Whether it's another stimulus check or you're not spending as much money, this is not the time to drop all of your money on vacation. Sure, something small is perfectly fine, but we've been hearing a lot about the gains on Wall Street, yet the job market isn't showing that. Even Michael Burry from The Big Short fame is talking about us being on the edge of a bubble. So please learn from the mistakes of those who experienced the Great Recession of 2008 and do not overextend yourself. Upgrade your lifestyles where you're gonna be in a position owing more than what you own. One of the biggest ways I've made a lot of money during my 22 years in business is having money stacked cash ready to pounce when opportunities present themselves, and usually those are during recessionary periods. Secondly, with the shift of small businesses and practices to digital, COVID scams on social media cost consumers $117 million in the first 6 months of 2020 alone. With so many businesses scrambling to bring their offerings online during the pandemic, it created a host of new vulnerabilities for criminals to exploit. This is only expected to gain more traction in 2021, so be careful. Lastly, take an inspection of your job, your career, even your workplace. Make sure you're in an industry that is recession-proof, pandemic-proof, innovative, and most importantly, that you enjoy, because life is short. Well, that's it for this episode of The Portfolio. Make sure you check out these two episodes previously done to catch back up. Also, here's some other videos you can check out here of what we talked about and how to leverage your stimulus checks, and also a hidden industry that can silently make you a millionaire, especially during tough times. With that being said, I love knowing your thoughts, your comments, your feedback, your questions. Drop it in the comment section below. And if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe and hit notifications to be alerted next time we upload our next episode. That being said, that's a wrap for this episode of The Portfolio. I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until we meet again, continue to live smart. Continue love smart and be money smart today.